Hi there. Now we will dive into Logic Pro X and see how the MIDI is configured in Logic Pro X for external instruments and different controllers. So let's get going. Okay, let's start Logic Pro X and see how the MIDI is configured within Logic Pro. And let's continue with an empty project and create an external MIDI. So now we have a MIDI track, and I have linked I have used an external instrument plugin that enables you to hook an external instrument into Logic Pro X. But before we go there, we need to see that how the MIDI is configured within Logic. That is taking place in Logic Pro, and then of course you need to go to Settings and MIDI. And there, in MIDI area, you have different options that you can work with. However, these are pretty okay as is. Of course, if you need to change them, you can of course do so. When we go here to see the kind of the different inputs that we use to kind of get MIDI controllers linked with Logic Pro X, like keyboards or pads or whatever you might use, or drum pads or things like that, you need to come over here and enable those ports that you want to use, like Machina. I have actually also linked a MIDI link external clock to be used if needed. Then for the Stream Deck, and yet another machine virtual input, as well as I have Machina MK3. I don't need input from these, so I'll take these away as I reinstalled and rebooted that device, the Mio XL, which is a MIDI bridge. And so if you go quickly to look over here, this is the MIDI configuration that I have in my system. So as if you remember from the channel intro or the studio intro, I have certain synthesizers that are using MIDI over USB, and they are here. So all the instruments that are using MIDI over USB can be seen here. But then I have some legacy synthesizers which work through the MIDI router that I have connected into my computer over USB. But anyway, from there it goes via MIDI cables to the older synthesizers. So yeah, I don't need those, so I'll take those all away, because there is no controllers underneath or behind these ports. I'll take all of them. I don't need the meta system either. I might need it for Logic, yes, but I don't need it for Ableton Live or MCU or Vienna, yes, please. V control, we could take a look. But then I would like to, no, maybe not from the OBX8 either. So I think I'm happy with these that I currently have here linked. And so this should be pretty good. I will use Lumi keys now to play some notes when connecting external synthesizers. So that's part of when it comes to MIDI input. But then when you are using external instruments or MIDI devices, and you want to send a synchronization message to those so that they are in the same sync, or they are in a sync with your digital audio workstations and Logic in this case, you need to go here. And these are actually project-based settings, as you can see. These are project settings. So we will then, of course, look and see that how to make these a bit more permanent in the future. But for this case, in order to synchronize your external instruments, you need to come over here and then select the ones that you want to send clock into, like in this case OBX8 for example. Then I want to synchronize my TR8S, which is a drum machine, so that that whenever I play the project, the both of these devices are synchronized with my DAW. So this is basically what you need to do in Logic, and that's the level of configuration you can do. Of course, there are even deeper type of things that you can deal with MIDI, but at this point, this is basically enough that and enough in a sense what you need to know, and what you need to be worried on. Of course, for a project settings, there are additional MIDI configuration data that you can enter and define if there is a need for you for that. But I will not go there in this, because this is just a high level to see that how to configure MIDI in different digital audio workstations. And this is basically how you do it in Logic. So there are several places where you need to touch if you need to configure things regarding on MIDI or MIDI synchronization when it goes out, so to send a MIDI clock, or when the MIDI inputs, what are the MIDI inputs that you are using in your digital audio workstation. So that's pretty much it from the MIDI configuration point of view, what comes into MIDI in and MIDI out. But then let's do just quick test and examples on then that how I would utilize this. So I created the MIDI track, and now I have a MIDI destination that basically I could select that if I want to send I want to kind of work with my OBX8. Now I'll just do it like in a simple way. So let's add an audio track to witness that the audio is coming in, and I'll select the stereo from here, and then an input which is basically coming from OBX8. And this is like 25 and 26. If I now arm this so that it's in a monitoring mode and play something. And now I need to remember what was the MIDI port that I used for OBX8. As I haven't configured this, so I'll pull my cheat sheet. And okay, it's a channel 10. So I need to change that to channel 10. In order for it to work. So here we go. And now we have it on channel 10. And then now the MIDI is going out and the sound is coming in. And so that's basically it when it comes to routing MIDI out. Okay, let's see how the MIDI controllers are added into Logic Pro X, specifically when we are talking about transport control and things like that, so that you can start and stop play from your MIDI controller. I will hook up this complete control into Logic Pro X and you will see what happens. So as you can see, it automatically detected the devices that Complete Control A Series wants to connect to Logic Pro X. And when I say connect, it will be added here. It automatically also takes the module and the ports and host names correctly. So this is an easy case in that sense, so that you don't need to do anything about it. And now if I press play. Oh, let's close this window first. We can come and revisit this again. But if I now press play, you can see that Logic starts playing, and then of course this one is an audio file, so there is no MIDI coming in. But if I would add an instrument, let's add just something very simple. Maybe detect the keys, maybe some pianos. Let's create that one. And Let's go to grand piano. So that's how it works, and now of course it also, this one now works as a MIDI controller, but also a transport controller. So if I open up a mixer, I could also from here change the volume of that track, and it basically follows the logic what you have here in the screen. Of course, when using a controller like the SSL UF8, it might be a lot easier to understand what you are controlling, and faders are always better than the knobs, but just kind of a simple example on that. Anyway, if you would need to manually add something, you need to go from into Logic Pro X and then Control Surfaces and then into Setup, and it will open up you with this window where you can then configure, like I have configured the UF8 to be used with Logic Pro X here, the model and so on and so forth. Others that I've been using with Logic is a Machina and the complete control that we just added. Similarly, if I would add another controller that is also having a kind of more than just the MIDI keys, it would appear automatically over there. If it doesn't, you can always manually add it and do it so. Okay, this concludes the session with MIDI configuration in Logic Pro X. Next, we will do it in Studio One. Remember to subscribe for the channel. Thanks for watching. Bye now.